everyone, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. I am so excited to share this book with you tonight. It's called Cheerful Chick, and it's not so much a bedtime story. It's more like a wake up and get happy kind of story, but I hope you like it. I love how her pom-poms are flowers from the farm. Do you notice that? She's cheering with pom-pom, flower pom-poms. And I wonder what the C on her shirt stands for. What do you think? Great guess. C is for chick, right? Cheerful chick. This book was written by Martha Brockenbrough and illustrated by Brian Wan. I want to dedicate it to my friend down in Georgia, little Miss Ava, who I know loves cheerleading too. I used to be a cheerleader, so I have a special place in my heart for cheerleaders as well. Cheerful chick. Once inside a chicken's nest, a dozen eggs, all grade A best, lay still and warm, their contents sleeping. All but one, who came out peeping. She just came out loud and proud, right? She was ready to cheer from the start. Look how happy and cheerful she looks. This sunny chicken loved to cheer, though grown-ups groaned when she came near. She needs to understand we're busy, and her cheering makes us dizzy. Cheerful Chick worked day and night until at last her moves felt right. And then she hatched her lifelong dream to build a barnyard cheering team. She got her muscles good and warm and did her moves with perfect form. Side splits, wing stands, super punches. Chicken shook her feather bunches. So cheerleaders do have to practice a lot. Their routines and their cheers and their moves, don't they? Yeah, and Cheerful Chick sure has been practicing. Then, because her dream was so big, she made her pitch to Mr. Pig. When I say three, yell P-I-G. This fella's jump's a treat to see. Mr. Pig, often grumpy, 'cause his slops were cold and lumpy, flicked his tail and said, shove off. I'm very busy at my trough. Chick shrugged her wings. I bet Miss Cow would like to do some cheering now. So Pig wasn't very impressed. He didn't want any parts of her cheerleading. I wonder if Miss Cow, though, will feel differently. Miss Cow knows all the wildest moves. Just watch her stand on two front hooves. Miss Cow just stood and blinked and chewed, and said, I'm not so in the mood. And so, without another peep, Chick went in search of Mr. Sheep. Now come on, farm gang, don't be drips. Let's count to 10 as Sheep does flips. But when she counted, Mr. Sheep did not do flips. He fell asleep. Poor Chicken hung her little head, her tiny heart filled up with dread. In the barn stood one last choice. She needed time to find her voice. Now snap your beak and stomp your feet, 'cause horse's high kicks can't be beat. Mrs. Horse just stared at Chick, who felt as though she might be sick. She touched her wings as if to pray, and Mrs. Horse responded, nay. Chick gave it everything she could, but nothing did her any good. She chucked her pom-poms in the trough, and then she ripped her sweater off. 'Cause no one cared about her dream, and no one wanted to be on her team. She whispered so that none would hear, who am I if I cannot cheer? That's all she wanted to do, and it's now like her dream is crushed. Chick sat and watched the full moon rise, and as she did, she realized she didn't need those other folk, just wings and legs and lots of yolk. She gave herself one last routine where every move was strong and clean. Then something happened as she cheered. A squad of fluffy friends appeared. Some cheerful chicks. 11 more. Not that she was keeping score. Oh, did these 11 chick friends come to help? Do they want to cheer too? Chicks rule. I wonder if she'll finally have her cheerleading squad that she always dreamed of. Well, hey now, horse, pig, cow, and sheep. This farm is full of chicks that cheep. We're two chicks, four chicks, six, a dozen. Watch us get this barnyard buzzin'. Since the grown-ups' work was done, they took part in the cheering fun. In Cheerful Chick, new dreams come true when chicks do what they're born to do. I'm so glad she didn't give up on her dream. Aren't you? Yeah, I'm really glad she gave it one last try. That was a fun story, and I hope you boys and girls enjoyed it at home as well. It's now time to sing our two lullabies, so I'm going to take out my star and moon. Take out yours at home if you have one. And if you don't, boys and girls, these are very easy to make. You can draw a star shape on construction paper and then draw a moon shape, cut them out, glue them to another piece of paper, and then glue them to a stick. This is just a popsicle stick. All right, here we go. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Very good. And now we'll sing our moon song. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. And God bless you, friends at home. Thanks so much for watching. And I'll see you again real soon on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. Good night.